A question that we all have to ask ourselves at some point, should I get a new computer, or at least upgrade my current one? Sometimes you ask yourself because your computer doesn't seem to be able to handle all your games and programs as fast as it used to. And other times, you're just trying to convince yourself that you need a new one so you can upgrade to the latest and greatest. So clearly, there's a lot to consider when thinking about this, and there really isn't any straightforward answer. And if you're hoping that I'm gonna give you an excuse to upgrade to a new computer that you don't need, well, I might do that. I think the most important thing to do first is to divide up the reasons for upgrading into two categories, what you need and what you want. And you have to be honest here with yourself because 99% of the time, when you hear someone say, oh, I need to do this or I need to get that, they don't actually need it. And hey, I'm no exception to this. Also, you need to consider the specifics of why you need a particular upgrade, whether it's one component or maybe even the entire computer. All right, let's start off with cases where you would need to upgrade your computer because these are relatively easy. Now, I'm not even talking about the obvious case where your computer is broken or something like that because that's a no-brainer. Rather, it may be that your computer is unable to do something that you consider really important. It doesn't have to be a matter of life and death. For example, perhaps all your friends just got a new video game, but your computer doesn't meet the minimum specs. Sure, you don't need to play the game in the sense that you won't die without it, but it would really suck to be the only one not able to join in on the fun. Or another example is if you're like me and you use your computer for work and it needs to be pretty powerful, in my case to render videos. So the longer and the higher resolution the video is, the more effects I use, the more time it will take to render. If you have a low power computer, sure, you could wait an entire day for the video to render, but what if it fails or you realize you made a mistake? That's another case where having a more powerful computer can probably save you way more time and money in the long run. And it doesn't need to be a job either. It could be a hobby that you spend a lot of time on. If you get to the point where your computer makes it not necessarily impossible, but very impractical to do something that you either need to or really want to do, then I think it's totally justifiable to upgrade. Now, what if you know that your computer is fully capable of doing everything you need, but there's still a little voice in your head telling you that it's just not good enough? If you're like me, your brain might jump through lots of hoops to convince you that getting the new shiny computer will solve all your problems. But you need to take a logical viewpoint here and not get ahead of ourselves. First thing to consider is what exactly do you want to get out of this new computer or an expensive new upgraded component? Do you want to be able to just run your favorite game on the next highest graphics setting? Or do you want to get higher frame rates or a higher resolution? Is there any other reason besides video game performance? And that last one is especially important because many times you don't necessarily have to upgrade the whole computer, just a component or two. So let's say your computer runs completely fine 99% of the time, but just can't run video games as fast as you'd like. Honestly, it probably wouldn't make sense to upgrade the whole computer just for game performance, unless it's really old. You'd probably be able to get away with just upgrading the graphics card. Or maybe it is the case where your computer overall is pretty slow and frustrating. I still wouldn't jump right into the new computer though, because there are a few options you can take beforehand. I think the biggest improvement you could make is upgrading from a regular hard disk to a solid state drive if you haven't gotten this already. People always seem to talk about getting more RAM as the be-all end-all of upgrading your computer, but that doesn't always necessarily even improve performance. Getting an SSD over a hard drive will almost always improve performance, because a mechanical hard drive is so slow compared to other components in your computer and often is the bottleneck. Anything from copying files to searching through folders in your Explorer or loading the map in a video game will be affected by the hard drive speed. Not only is this because SSDs have faster read and write speeds in general, but also because you don't have to worry about fragmentation with them. In a hard drive, you see, files are stored all over the physical platters, which means that if you have to access lots of little different files at once, the drive head has to physically move back and forth more to read them, which relatively takes a long time. Now, with a solid state drive, there is no drive head, so files can be accessed pretty much instantly no matter what. So seriously, try upgrading to an SSD before you do anything else, I think. Now, let's say you already have an SSD, but the computer is still pretty slow. Unless it's slow during video games, upgrading your graphics card probably won't help, so let's scratch that off. That leaves two main components, the RAM and the CPU. Now, this is tricky because a bottleneck in either might manifest itself very similarly. If you don't have enough RAM or your RAM is very slow, it doesn't matter how fast your CPU is because the RAM can't queue up enough data to be processed fast enough. And oppositely, if you have a slow CPU and fast RAM, even though the RAM can queue up data to be processed quickly, the CPU can only do it slowly anyway. Now, I will say that I think 9 times out of 10, the main bottleneck will be the CPU, especially if the computer is old. But the case where RAM will be a big factor is either if you just don't have nearly enough at all, or if you're running some seriously heavy hitter programs, or a ton of programs in the background at all times. That's because most programs will only ever use as much RAM as it needs to, and most programs really don't need that much at all. In my opinion, these days, if you have less than 8 gigabytes of RAM, then you might very well be causing a noticeable bottleneck in your computer because of that. And it would probably be worth it to add more, even if you only run basic programs. I think 8 gigabytes is a reasonable minimum for anyone. Between 8 and 16 gigabytes will certainly depend on what kinds of programs you're running. If you play video games but don't really run any other heavy-duty programs like a video or photo editor, or you don't really have that many programs running at once in the background, you could probably justify going up to about 12 gigabytes. Above that, though, is probably overkill, and I would be surprised if you noticed any difference from 12 to 16, for example. As for more than 16 gigabytes, well, if you're someone who needs that much, you'd know it. Like I mentioned before, this would be for people who do a lot of multimedia editing, use CAD software, deal with huge databases, virtual machines, that sort of thing. In those cases, the software will pretty much use as much RAM as you can throw at it, especially when larger file sizes are involved. And this is within reason, of course. It's not like I'd recommend to anyone to go out and get 100 gigabytes of RAM. Anyway, what I would suggest is if you have 8 gigabytes of RAM or less, and you're willing to spend a little bit more on an extra 4 gigabytes, it probably would be worth it, assuming you aren't happy with your current performance. Oh, and finally, one extra thing you can do if you're not really sure if you have enough is check with a built-in Windows program called the Resource Monitor, and that will let you see how much RAM is being used by each program to see if you're bottlenecking. Now, if you know anything about building computers, or maybe not even, you probably realize that upgrading only your CPU really just doesn't make any sense. If your CPU is too slow, you may as well go get a whole new computer. Though, you could of course reuse some other components if you've upgraded them more recently, but I'm getting ahead of myself. And if you're wondering why you can't just upgrade your CPU, well, there are a couple reasons. First of all, CPU sockets on motherboards change every few years as new CPUs come out. So chances are, if you buy a brand new CPU, it wouldn't even fit into your current motherboard. And even if it did, your other components would still be old and you'd have everything else causing bottlenecks. It just wouldn't make sense. However, I do need to mention that if you know what you're doing or you're willing to learn, instead of buying a whole new computer, you might be able to overclock your current CPU. That's depending on the CPU itself and your cooling situation, but you could definitely squeeze out some extra power. Of course, that is beyond the scope of this video, so I'm not gonna get into that. Now, as I just mentioned, if you buy a new computer, you still might be able to reuse some of your old components to save money, but you'd really only wanna do this if you had upgraded those recently enough where they're still decent. But obviously, you can only really do this if you build your own PC, because you can't exactly buy a new computer off the shelf with no RAM or hard drive. So for example, if your computer is several years old, but just last year you bought a brand new graphics card for it, well, duh, reusing it is a great way to save some money. Or you could cannibalize a fan or two if they're good ones. And in some cases, you might even be able to transfer your license of Windows to the new machine, but not always. I'm not gonna get into that. However, you should also consider that many times, pre-built PCs are actually cheaper than buying every piece of hardware individually. So unless you know that you want to build your own, don't bother doing so just so you can reuse your CD drive or something like that. For example, you could find that for the same price as building a PC without a graphics card to use your current one, you could buy a pre-built one with an even better graphics card. Though I think most of the time, you should already have an idea of whether you want to build your own anyway. So let's tie this all together. I hope I can assume that most of you can figure out whether you need to get a new computer or upgrade. And if you just want to, then it's gonna come down to how much you're willing to spend and how big of a difference it will make. Individual components are usually an easier decision because they're obviously cheaper and don't take as much work as setting up a whole new computer. I mean, in my opinion, I tend to only upgrade my entire computer when I need to, mostly because it's a huge pain to set everything up again, plus it costs way more. I mean, I built my current computer in 2014, and I think it still runs completely fine for my purposes, though I have upgraded the graphics card since then, and I've actually overclocked my CPU since the beginning. So in my case, I definitely think I'll be able to get at least another year out of this guy, as long as nothing breaks. All right, so I think that's it. In the end, you really just have to make the decision yourself. I just hope I'm able to give you some things to think about that might help. But anyway, I'd love to know what you guys think. Like, if you like to upgrade your computer as often as possible, how come? And also, if you want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here, including some ways to speed up your computer without buying anything. And if you want to subscribe, I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. Should be worth it. So thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.